Jimmy Schliegelmeyer is, of course, a candidate for parish council. We're at the Annie Awards. I guess when you're on the campaign trail, you have to go where the crowds are. And boy, what a tremendous crowd the Tangipahoa Chamber had today.
Well, absolutely. We had so many wonderful people here at the crowd today. Over 400 people sitting in chairs and listening to the recipients here today. And such an honor to be here to recognize the recipients.
Meanwhile, back at the parish council, I know you're sort of a river rat, as everybody is south of I-12. And what do you think about the rock jetty now being greatly expanded? It's done wonderful things at the mouth of the Tangipahoa River, causing cypress and other vegetation to regrow. And there's optimism now that it'll do even more than that in years to come.
Right. Well, the rock jetty, you know, it protects the land shore, the shoreline, so that way that all the mulch and things behind it, you know, can regenerate and also create land there behind it. But you know, it also is for fishing and things like that. I mean, people like to fish the jetties and things like that, too, the rock jetties.
Any ideas you have on what else we can do for our valuable wetlands in the south part of the parish? We've lost a good bit.
Yeah, you know, saltwater intrusion on our freshwater lakes, you know, is always bad for the vegetation and the trees and things like that. But, you know, everything seems to just come full circle on a lot of things, you know, but we also could help with that, with the rock jetties and cultivations and planting the trees. I mean, we have a project now at the port where they're planting over 1 million cypress trees out there in the swamps and flagging them and things like that. So hopefully that project will be completed here soon.
That's great. You know, there's thought that Kim Coates brought a unique thing on the parish council, a unique perspective that if you're successful, you will take that mantle on, and that is namely concerned about the environment, concerned about litter, concerned about issues that they were important before, but she was always the voice, like getting the Lake Maurepas resolution passed recently and things like that.
Yeah, I mean, we got to, the people down there, they live down there, they down there every weekend, and we just got to protect what we got down there in the lake, and both Lake Maurepas and Lake Pontchartrain, you know, the Tangipahoa River and all that over there. I mean, we got to keep everything litter free.
Well, in the meantime, as you go down, I mean, those various roads in your district, let's back up a second. Where is the new district?
So the new district is going to go from Adams Road 22 to Dutch Lane, and then Dutch Lane down to Whiskey Island, and then all the way to Manshack, back up the railroad tracks to Ash Street to Estabrook all the way to Seltzer's Creek, and it takes in the whole city limits of Ponchatoula.
What are people saying they're concerned about from the parish council as you campaign and talk to them?
So the concerns in our area is mainly traffic. We have a lot of traffic. I mean, we just got the new red light there at the end of Punkin Center there. I mean, that's going to be a great help with exiting on the Punkin Center onto the Highway 22 West there. And so, you know, my grandfather told me 30, 40 years ago, he said just about every intersection on Highway 22 will probably have a red light sometime, maybe not in his and maybe not in mine. But one day we will have a red light at every intersection.
Because Pumpkin Center Road comes in at a higher plane than 22, that intersection was terrible because you couldn't see all the oncoming traffic.
Yeah, when you pull in a camper or a trailer or a boat behind your truck and that embankment that you're trying to exit or to get onto the Highway 22, I always just try to bypass that and go around the interstates, you know, and come into the Ponchatoula exits.
What other projects would you like to see if you get it on the parish council?
So right now, I mean, the overlayments of our streets and our with all of the infrastructures that's going on in our area, I mean, you know, and I want to also work with the fire departments and the police departments and our people that serve the community every day. We want to make sure that they got the necessary things that they need in front of them.
You know, that's a good point. I don't know how many people realize it, but if you're on the parish council, you're also on the drainage board and you're on the fire board that oversees all the fire departments in the parish.
Correct. I mean, our fire department, you know, we get the tax bases and things like that, but you know, they're stretched real thin every day with the and populations of the community.
They're talking about a study of the way the funds are allocated to the fire departments, and chances are, if you get elected, one of the first things that's going to happen is you'll get to see the results of that study. And you know, I hear that, and I think it's a good idea, but the problem I would see is, it looks to me like it's going pretty well as it is. You can always improve something, But then again, do you really want to fix something that's not broke? What do you think?
Well, I mean, the study is also there to help, you know, with the way the money is spent in our fire departments and how it's dispersed over to all the fire departments parish-wide, not only City of Hammond, City of Ponchatoula, or you know, or LaRonja, you know, but all our fire departments, they all need their the equipment that they need to in case of an emergency, so that way they're well-equipped for that.
What else do you want to share with us?
I just want to congratulate all the recipients. Patricia Hebert is my wife's aunt, and I just want to greatly congratulate her and Sarah Mitchell, I mean, classmate of mine, and, you know, such a wonderful tribute to what all they do to offer all the people. And thank Miss Mulkey for being here and speaking.
I'm beginning to think we need some kind of an annual award for men.
Well, you know, we do everything we can in our community every day. I mean, that's what I've 24 years of community service and helping the students and helping the band boosters and the Strawberry Festival and all the organizations involved. You know, that's just something we do every day.